Hey, I'm Nick. We created that because most people overpay for cars. My money's the best deal. Daddy saves users over $800 a year on average. Go to daddy.com. We'll stop overpaying for car insurance. Just always talk about dog food. Dog food. You know, he's got a dog food. Single rock bars on it. Her skin's better. She's more active. If I can invest in her health and be proactive before it. My hair loss was a reminder of my age. I started noticing losing my hair in my late 20s. What really stuck out about it to me was the confidentiality aspect. It made me feel like I could tell them anything. When I started pursuing the goals, I got excited. It makes me feel younger. My relationship with my hair is fantastic. It just trains my pocket. I love it. And the fact that it works. This morning, the U.S. sports crowd since the pandemic began. Andy Schultz has more in the Bleacher Report. And that's our kid.
you see other sporty and looking fitties going to NASCAR, you got the possibility. How do you guys do it? I can't even say that you guys can win NASCAR. That's an ask, sure. And then for golf, and golf has been interesting. You're really up close. And this has been a challenge for you, too, Matt, because you're the one guy to pair up. It certainly has been an interesting year. You know, you're wearing all your safety gear, your mask, you know, your social distancing. You know, you're used to being, you know, like, you know, when you're on the field, and you're 2 feet from your interviewer, and your interviewee, and now you're 6 feet apart, and you're having to yell your question, and we've got boom lights. But that all goes back to, you know, working without a manual, and everybody coming together, compiling all the different ideas to say, okay, how can we produce this event, produce it at the quality that we're used to? And I'm very proud of how we pulled it off this year.
Well, Fox Sports did a great job, and so did you, Matt. Thank you very much. So, I hope you can sleep in over the weekend, because you guys have been very busy.
Reports that's the Empire State Building. Jedediah, great job today. We'll see you on the weekend. Katie Papagen tomorrow. And Steve, we have to urge people to set their DVRs and find out a way to do it. The directions are often included. You also, right? Yeah. Use your ratchet set. Need a set, not a DVR. I don't think you need it, but I'm not sure. Have it in.
Sandra, good morning to you. I'm John Roberts in Washington today. A demonstration on the Brooklyn Bridge turns ugly, leaving four officers injured, including New York's top uniformed cop, the chief of the Department of Terrorist Lying, the NYPD, now asking for help to identify suspects as police release new video of one person running from the scene. Meanwhile, President Trump announcing plans to crack down as violence spirals out of control. The president saying he will introduce a new federal law enforcement initiative next week.
We have a city that had out of control. One of them was in Chicago. 68 people were shot and 18 died last week. I'm not going to put up with that. So that's for our next discussion.
Meanwhile, the National Police Board, which has appointed Joe Biden in the past, now endorsing President Trump for re-election.
A lot to talk about this morning. Let's get right to it. President Fisher, who joins us now live from the White House. Good morning, President.
Hey, good morning, Donald. It turns out that the president's push to defend the police instead of defunding them has really paid off. With this endorsement, President Trump has essentially solidified his stance as the law and order president. In a statement put out just last night announcing this endorsement, the National Association of Police Organizations said our endorsement recognizes your steadfast and very public support for our men and women on the front lines, especially during this time of unfair and inaccurate appropriately directed at our members by so many. And this endorsement is particularly painful for Joe Biden because the organization had endorsed your Ronald Biden ticket back in 2008 and in 2012. Now, Joe Biden does not support defunding the police, but he has said that some funding should be redirected. And at the same time, your President Trump saying that he's been threatening federal intervention in Democrat-run cities where he believes that the spikes in violence have really gotten out of control. And he announced in the Oval Office yesterday, John, that he'll be having a big news conference about that next week. So add it all up, that announcement is not the police union and President Trump. He's solidifying his stance as one more president, John.
So it's something that the president welcomes, but with Joe Biden leading in the distributed polls, the president announcing last night a big shakeout in his campaign. What's going on?
Yeah, this caught a lot of campaign staffers it really was something that we talked about for quite some time, and it appeared that the final draw for Brad Parscale was that rally in Tulsa, Oklahoma, a few weeks ago, in which he overpromised and underdelivered on turnout. Now he's going back to the 2016, which is overseeing the campaign's digital operation and data collection, which is really his area of expertise. Well, the deputy campaign manager, most deputy and a long-time manager cooperative, is going to step up to the top job left a couple months before the election. And it is this painful round of this poll, and showing the president behind in several key swing states and nationally. This is the real clear politics after the poll, and it has gone up by more than 8 points. So, this campaign manager has a big job ahead of him in front of all of us around the pond before election day.
Certainly does. President Trump has seen a lot of faith. Christian Boris at the White House. Christian, thanks. Trump 2020 campaign national press secretary Hogan Gidley will join us at 9:30 on the campaign shakeup, the latest polls, and Trump team strategy going forward in those developments.
All right, thank you, John. So, all that was written on the campaign shakeup, I should say. James Sender, who is our deputy editor of the Wall Street Journal, editorial page, and a Fox News contributor. James, good morning. Thanks for the show with you this morning. I really want to get to this piece by Carl Rove, because he joined us yesterday, and he said it would be coming out this morning here in the Wall Street Journal. 2020 gives new meaning to viral campaign. Social distancing will protect Biden from gaffes and raise the stakes of the debates. He talked about a completely new landscape for campaigning out there as the Trump campaign shakes things up. Will we see a shift in strategy?
Well, I think we probably will see a shift in strategy for sure. I mean, the president, is got to be by the 10-point gap in the bill, at least showing up in the polls. And that cannot just come out of the Trump base. I mean, there was a theory out there for some time that Brad Parscale would be able to reach untapped members of the white blue-collar class out there that did not vote for Donald Trump in 2016 and put them across the finish line. But the polls show that they simply keep going south among independents and suburban women to the point now where the Wall Street Journal poll is down by 10 points. So I think Brad Parscale is just basically the fall guy here. It's inevitable, and if it comes wrong when something like this happens, and Bill stepped in, it's going to step in there. But make no mistake, it will be the president himself who decides which direction to take his campaign. And obviously, he has some decisions to make about where it's going, what strategy he needs to pursue. And Carl Rove is right. In a world of social distancing, simply doing the rallies is not going to work. They have to come up with an alternative to those big rallies.
That's what that looks like. Rove writes this. Gone are the big rallies, endless bus tours, and they've been going from here to here, and it is hopscotch across battleground states. Each campaign, if it's wise, will plan its social media more carefully to send messages for the day and deploy more surrogates to hit local television and newspapers. The latter reflects a return to a time before air travel when a party's message was amplified by powerful voices across the U.S. So you wonder how the Trump campaign and the Biden campaign, for that matter, is going to adapt to that thing.
Well, especially with Joe Biden, I mean, the question has been, can Joe Biden go out in public and walk and chew gum at the same time as someone said about a former president? That remains to be seen. Joe Biden has his own challenges, and make no mistake about it. And we're going to find out whether Biden can go out there and sustain an articulate campaign. As the President Trump, this is a media-centric individual and president, and he's going to be front and center one way or another. He's not going to be having surrogates running this campaign for him to any great extent. And I do think that Mount Rushmore speech that he gave just before 4th of July should be seen as a template. It was a serious and substantive.